Tell the world for me. We love, because God first loved us. 1 John 4:19. About 14 years ago, I stood watching my university students file into the classroom for the opening session in my Theology of Faith class. That was the first time I saw Tommy. He was combing his long hair that hung 6 inches below his shoulder. I know it's what's in your head, not on it, that counts. I was unprepared for Tommy. It turned out that Tommy was an atheist, he didn't believe in God at all, but here he was taking a Theology of Faith class, now that's strange. He constantly objected to or smirked at the possibility of an unconditionally loving God. We lived in relative peace for one semester, although, at times, he was a pain in the back pew. At the end of the course when he turned in his final exam, he asked in a slightly cynical tone, "Do you ever think I'll find God?" I decided on a little shock therapy. "No." "Oh," he responded. "I thought that was the product you were pushing." I let him get 5 steps from the door, then called out, "Tommy. I don't think you'll ever find him. But I am certain that he will find you." Tommy just shrugged and left. I felt slightly disappointed that he had missed my clever line. Later I heard that Tommy had graduated, and I was grateful, certain that he was out of my life. I was wrong. Then came a report, Tommy had terminal cancer. Before I could search him out, he came to me. When he came into my office his body was badly wasted, and his long hair had fallen out because of chemotherapy. But his eyes were bright and his voice was firm for the first time in a long time. "Tommy, I've thought about you so often. I hear you are sick." "Oh, yes, very sick. I have cancer. It's a matter of weeks. Can you talk about it?" "Sure, what would you like to know?" "What's it like to be 24 and know you are dying?" "Well, it could be worse."
"Like what?"
"Well, like being 50 and having no values or ideals. Like being 50 and thinking that booze, seducing women, and making money are the real biggies in life." "I really came to see you about is something you said to me on the last day of class. I asked if you ever thought I would find God and you said no, which surprised me. Then you said, but he will find you." I thought about that a lot, even though my search was hardly intense at the time. But when the doctors removed a lump from my groin and told me it was malignant, I got serious about locating God. And when the malignancy spread to my vital organs, I really began banging against the doors of heaven. But nothing happened. Well, one day I woke up, and instead of throwing a few more futile appeals to a God who may or may not exist, I just quit. I decided to spend what time I had left doing something more profitable. I thought about you and something you had said in one of your lectures, the essential sadness is to go through life without loving. But it would be equally sad to leave this world without telling those you love that you loved them. So I began with the hardest one, my dad. He was reading the paper when I approached him. "Dad, I would like to talk to you."
"Well, talk," he replied.
"I love you, Dad. I just wanted you to know." Tommy smiled at me and said with obvious satisfaction, as he told me how his dad dropped the newspaper, hugged him and they had spent the night talking even though Dad had to go to work the next morning. Mom and little brother were a lot easier to talk with. Here I was, in the shadow of death, and I was just beginning to open up to all those people I love. Then one day I turned around and God was there. He didn't come to me when I pleaded with him. I guess God does things on his own timetable. The important thing is you were right. He found me even after I stopped looking for him. I gasped, "I think you're saying something much more important than you realize. When you open yourself up to love, you can find God." Tommy and I met once more before his death. "Would you tell the whole world that God is love and once you find love you will find God standing there with his arms open to give you his warm, loving, and welcoming embrace?" "Yes, Tommy, I'll tell everyone I can."